Pelican of London. A tall ship with a difference. After 12 years of reconstruction, Tallship Pelican is finally ready for her first sea trials. And for the first time, Adventure Under Sail is able to offer an inspirational range of training voyages, Caribbean cruises, and tailor-made holidays. The project is the brainchild of Graham Neilson. Graham left the Royal Navy as a commander in 1982. Since then, he's been committed to the training of young people through long ocean voyages under sail.
The mission of the ship is the training of young people, or giving them the opportunity to experience living in close proximity, traveling the world together, keeping watches, watching the stars, and generally appreciating nature very close to it.
Graham acquired Pelican in Norway in 1995, where she was working as a coaster. Pelican was built in France in 1946 to work in the Arctic. Her steel hull was based on the clippers of the 19th century. Graham was convinced she would make a perfect sailing ship. The Pelican was taken to Dorset to be reconstructed from keel to masthead. It was a massive undertaking. The whole interior was ripped out. The wheelhouse was removed. The hold was cut out and the hull stripped back to bare steel plates. But after 3 years of work, Graham was struck by the sheer scale of what he'd taken on.
The lowest point of the project was the third winter, when I suddenly realized the enormity of the project, the lack of funds, and my diminishing confidence led me to suspect that we could have, at the end of the day, an unsaleable product.
Over the next 9 years of patient work, the hull was refitted for her new life as a training ship. Accommodation replaced the cargo hold. A long poop was added for mess room, galley, and living space. She was fitted with 40 tons of ballast for stability. She was painted with over 7,000 litres of paint and anti-fouling, and decked with sustainably harvested Indonesian saroya. She was fitted with tanks for 12 tons of fresh water and 15 tons of fuel. Her forecastle was stripped out to create a bosun's cabin and workshop. The accommodation was arranged on two decks. The main deck houses the galley, mess, saloon, communication station, and master's cabin. On the lower deck are more cabins. Also on the lower deck is the engine room, complete with sewage treatment plant and fresh water maker, allowing Pelican to work in the most ecologically sensitive areas in the world. The biggest and the most important challenge of the whole construction was designing her new sail plan.
The turning point of the whole mission was my fortuitous meeting with Philip Good.
Renowned sail designer Philip Good had been experimenting with a design based on the Barbary pirate Chebec, the most successful corsair of the Mediterranean for over 200 years.
It was Philip's enthusiasm for the rig of the Barbary Coast pirate ships, the Shebeck, that convinced me that if we were to incorporate this onto the Pelican, we had a runner for the future.
The Barbary pirates combined the massive triangular foresail of the Shebeck for upwind capability, with the squaresails of a square rigger on the mainmast for downwind power. To sail close to the wind, the Barbary pirates braced the yards of the squaresails at a much tighter angle than normal by easing the halyards. They ended up with a ship that was faster and more maneuverable than anything else on the sea. Philip Good set about replicating the design in a unique modern rig. The Pelican was to combine square and triangular sails for downwind power and upwind agility. The design was tested in Mallorca on a 1/20th scale model. In trials, the 3.5-meter Pelicanina was perfectly balanced. Like all square riggers, she was powerful and stable downwind. But the real strength of the design was in allowing the squaresails to be braced at 20 degrees, giving the rig much greater upwind performance than a traditional square rigger. Pelicanina was a resounding success. The secrets of the Barbary forebears had been revealed. It was time to translate this discovery into the full-size tall ship Pelican. This unique rig required three single-pole masts. These were built in the Midlands in 20-sided hollow steel sections. The tallest of them was 100 feet long. Finally, after 12 years, 3 miles of rope and wire, and more man-hours than can be counted, Tallship Pelican was ready to set sail on her maiden voyage. Pelican's maiden voyage is a passage to St. Lucia, via Lisbon, Madeira, south as far as the Cape Verde Islands, and west to Barbados.
We love you.
Her 32 trainees will be on board for the next 3 months. They range from 17 to over 70. Their skipper on the maiden voyage is Darren Nags.
It's an absolutely life-changing experience from day one. I mean, they're in a hostile environment, or potentially hostile environment. They're out of their comfort zone in a big way. They'll have a vertical learning curve to look forward to.
As they cross the Atlantic, the trainees will learn how to handle the sails and experience the excitement of sailing a tall ship.
I've been up to the first platform. You can see it there, just the first platform. And I kind of stood there and then got a bit scared. So the yard, like climbing out on the rope to the yards to change the sails, haven't done, like completed that yet. Okay. By the end of the voyage, I hope to get up the mast in record time, race up there and do it without assistance, hopefully.
And when we call it a station in harbour, four apart ship go forward.
Crucially, they'll also learn to work and live as a team, depending on each other for their every need. For skipper Darren, sailing the Pelican is a whole new experience.
Well, she's the handiest sailing ship that I've ever sailed. She sails a lot closer to the wind than any other vessel I've been on. She's very, very handy. She's responsive. She's lively. It's like sailing a laser after being on a supertanker, really.
Pelican is owned by a partnership of individuals whose lives have taught them that being at sea, close to nature, with the exhilaration of sailing a tall ship, is an inspirational experience. You can't always choose your weather for a departure, but one thing is certain. On the Pelican, every day is an adventure.